exercises that we've got for Tai Chi, simply looking at Tai Chi without looking at it in terms of or anything like that. What we've got here is basic form, push hands, 7-point body push exercises, qigongs, 5 loosening exercises, and then applications. And the reason we do applications is to make people aware of what they can do to defend themselves, I guess, and also how the movement is used for later on when we go on to push hands. 7-point body push is an exercise used later on to learn how to compress any line of force. Okay, so if a force, line of force comes in, I learn how to sink and relax with that force. So later on, I learn to do that naturally. And when I learn to do that naturally, I can spit the person out without thinking about it, just instinctive. So that's called an issue. We can pop someone out, just to explain very basically. Just try and get up all the concepts. When I bring someone in, the issue becomes part of my listening. Okay, so that's a point you're going to get to in this training. You're going to do it very instinctively. Now, within all these exercises, your training has an objective of relaxing, okay? Creating supreme yin energy. Yin as in inwards, as in negative, positive as in outwards. Okay, so that's a yang. So we create a supreme yang energy as an explosive force, which isn't a release of force. Okay, it's you're taking in your opponent's yin. Okay, you've got the yin, you're taking in the yang, so that's the equinox of motion. You create the yin, which is the negative, and you suck them in like that. Okay, and you take them down and you spit them out, and that creates a yang. Get it? Okay, so we've got supreme yin creates supreme yang. Okay, that's the basic theory. Now, what you need to do to make this happen is create a gap within your body. Okay, so where do we have our gaps? We've got our limbs, okay, our joints here. Now, with our joints, we've got two parts. What happens when we relax and we practice to relax all the time is that they have a gap here, okay, with the tendons and ligaments. When we tense, these tendons and ligaments push together, okay, but when we relax, they come apart again. Okay, so I take in the force, all right, as I'm relaxed the whole time. I don't run away from it, I let the force push me in, into the ground. So again, we're taking that horizontal plane of energy and turning it into a vertical plane of energy here. So when it comes in, I'm relaxed like this. And when all my weight is taken down to my legs, when it's all taken in and I can't go any further down, I'm compressed like a spring. Okay, so I go like this. Now, because I'm compressed, my limbs have tightened. Now, all I have to do is think. Okay, this is mental. Don't think, push, think, relax. Sinking is physical, this part. Relaxing is mental. And that's what you need to gain from training. Okay, so there's the basic concepts of how you can not so much become immortal, as they say, but respond to any attack based on a philosophy. Because you're always sinking and relaxing, you're not thinking about how am I going to spit them out. You're not even thinking at all. You're simply responding instinctively. And how you learn to do that effectively is through practice. Okay, so whatever the attack comes, you have to stick to it. You use that force to compress yourself into the ground. Once you're compressed, your body compresses like a spring like this. Once you think relax, or open up again, and that's how they spit out.